I have been at Michigan State for 41 years now. I've been a weed scientist. I've worked in weed science at Michigan State for about 30 years. Primarily, I have been a vegetable weed specialist, but then a number of years ago, I was asked to take on the fruit work as well, about 15 to 20 years ago. So I've been doing fruit weed control for the last 15 or 20 years, and I'm still doing vegetable work as well. The weed control is probably one of the major activities of any grower, any farmer, of any type of crop. It's not quite as exciting as some of the serious insect and disease problems that we've encountered recently, but it's ongoing effort and ongoing expense. So growers, I think, understand to a large extent that they have to control the weeds. It is an activity that has to be done, but sometimes it gets placed on the back burner because they have other things to do and other more immediate problems, such as the insects and the diseases. We try to come up with a plan, a year-long or multi-year plan that the growers can work with and follow that. And if they stick with the plans, they normally can get a high level of, high degree of weed control. And that's my objective, is to try to help the growers improve their production, increase the productivity of their orchards, and get better quality.
All my years at Michigan State University, I have seen consistent positive contributions from Bernie for the fruit and vegetable industries of Michigan, in particular because he has worked hard at providing solutions in areas of weed science for our specialty crop producers. Bernie has a legacy in that he has developed a nationally renowned program and reputation that I hope and trust will continue at Michigan State University.
The type of work I do here at Clarksville is primarily long-term residual herbicides. We apply either in the fall or in the spring, and then we essentially count weeds and rate weed control through the season. In the last few years, there have been several new herbicides that have been registered for use in the crop itself with a shorter pre-harvest interval, so application in May or June. And so we've been working with those and trying to increase the number of registrations of new labels for herbicides. So that's what we're doing here at Clarksville. I do have contact with growers all the time, either personal visits or phone calls or emails. So we keep track very closely of what are the issues, what are they worried about, what are they doing. The work that we have done is essentially trying to obtain new herbicide labels, new registrations for products that we know work. We do the first initial testings in the field to find out what works. The biggest issue with herbicides, of course, is crop injury. We don't want to hurt the crop. If we find herbicides that are better than what we've been using or are a different mode of action and they don't injure the crop, then we work through the IR4 office, which is part of USDA, to obtain these registrations. Ultimately, all of our work is to support the growers in Michigan, and when they recognize those of us at MSU for doing our work, that's really quite gratifying and satisfying, and I thank the industry immensely for this award.
Congratulations to Bernie Zandstra on receiving the 2018 Distinguished Service Award.